Hey Linux Explorers, welcome back to Fix My Linux, where we solve Linux issues one fix at a time. If you have any website running on a port other than 80 and you want to provide public access without including the port number in the URL, the best solution is to use Nginx Reverse Proxy. Nginx can accept connection requests on port 80 and forward them to another IP address and port, eliminating the need to remember the IP with the port number. A great use case for this is when you change the backend server. You only need to update the IP address and port in the reverse proxy configuration, and users can continue accessing the website without any changes on their end. Starting with Ubuntu server first, let's start the Ubuntu server and retrieve its IP address so we can connect via SSH and manage it easily from another system. Type ipanow, open the terminal on another system from which you want to connect. Before connecting via SSH, it's a good practice to check connectivity between both systems using the ping command. Ping-C3 server IP address. If you see 0% packet loss, the connection is good. If you get 100% packet loss, check the network connectivity first. Connecting via SSH, use the following command to establish an SSH connection. SSH fixmylinux at 192.168.56.101 type yes when prompted. The first time you connect to a system via SSH, it will ask for confirmation, enter your password, and press enter. Now we are successfully logged into the Ubuntu server with Nginx installed, checking Nginx status. To verify if Nginx is running, use sudo service nginx status. If the service is active and running, everything is working correctly. Testing Nginx access. Check the default Nginx website using curl localhost. To verify access from another system, open a browser and enter the server's IP address. If you see the message "Welcome to Nginx," it confirms that Nginx is working properly. Setting up Nginx as a reverse proxy. Now let's create a simple HTML file to demonstrate the reverse proxy setup. If you are unfamiliar with VS Code, it is a powerful IDE for developers with excellent support for various programming languages and extensions. You can check out my previous video on installing VS Code on Ubuntu for more details. Now, let's test the sample website using the Live Server extension. Right-click the HTML file and select Open with Live Server. This will automatically open the URL in your default web browser. Copy the URL as we will add it to the Nginx default web server configuration. By the way, the Live Server extension is very helpful during development. You can find and install it via the VS Code Extensions tab. Configuring Nginx Reverse Proxy. Navigate to the Nginx Sites Available directory. cd /etc/nginx/sites-available. List the files. Else, you should see the default Nginx configuration file. Open it using the nanotext editor. Sudo nano default, locate the location block using the arrow keys and add the following line. Proxy pass URL to pass proxy connection. Replace URL to pass proxy connection with your actual URL. For example, proxy pass http://192.168.561:5500/webserver1.html. Important. Remember to add a semicolon at the end of the line, otherwise Nginx will not work. Troubleshooting Nginx configuration errors. Let's see what happens if you forget the semicolon. Save the file using Ctrl+X, then restart Nginx. Sudo service nginx restart. If it fails, check the error message by running sudo service nginx status. In this case, the error message indicates an issue on line 53. Reopen the configuration file. Sudo nano default. Enable line numbers for easy navigation. You'll see that the missing semicolon caused the issue. Fix it by adding semicolon, then save and exit. Fixing firewall issues. If the reverse proxy does not work, check the firewall status. Sudo UFW status. To allow access to port 5500 from a specific IP address, run sudo UFW allow to any port 5500 from 192.168.56.101. Reload the firewall, sudo ufw reload. Now test the URL again from the Ubuntu server, curl 192.168.56.101:5500/webserver1.html. If everything works fine, add the correct IP in the Nginx default configuration file and restart. Nginx sudo service Nginx restart final testing check if the reverse proxy is working by accessing localhost curl localhost. Now open your web browser and reload the website at the server's IP address on port 80. If everything is set up correctly, the site hosted on port 5500 on another system is now accessible through Nginx on port 80. Reverting changes for testing. If you want to test what happens when the reverse proxy is removed, comment out the proxy pass line by adding number sign at the beginning. Save the file, restart Nginx, and refresh the browser. It will now show the default Nginx page again. Uncomment the line and reload Nginx to restore the reverse proxy functionality. Now you know how to set up an Nginx reverse proxy to forward requests from port 80 to another port, making it easier to access websites without remembering IP and port. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you never miss a Linux fix. Have a question or facing issues? Drop a comment below and I'll help you out. See you in the next Linux adventure, only on Fix My Linux.